Okay, so today we will start from this part, gravitational force. I hope you don't have any more doubt from the frictional force part. So let's see what is gravitational force. This one you have also learnt in previous class and in SST also. So you already know it. Let's see what is written in the book. What is gravitational force? The gravitational force is that force which pulls the object towards the center of the earth. So if you throw anything to the upward direction, it will, after some time, it will drop down, drop to the, it will come to the downward direction, okay, towards the earth center. So there is a force. The force that you will apply to the object, suppose you have a ball, you are throwing it to the upward direction. So the force that you are applying to the ball, it is moving the ball, it is helping the ball to move to the upward direction. But that is not the force that is applied by you that will cause the fall of the ball, right? So after some time, you will see that ball is falling to the downward direction. Then what is the force that is that acts on the ball that makes it fall to the downward direction? That is the gravitational force. This is not the force that you have applied on the ball. This is the gravitational force that pulls any object towards the center of the earth. The force keeps all things on the earth bound to it. So this is the reason, this is why due to the presence of this gravitational force, everything is bound to the earth's ground. You all know that we all live to the outermost layer of the earth. What is the name of the outermost layer of the earth? What is it called?
Crust.
Crust. Very good. That is correct. Very good. So earth's crust. So we are all stuck to the earth's crust, right? We don't fall down from the earth's crust. No, we will never fall down from the earth's crust. Why? Because of the gravitational force. The gravitational force is always attracting us in every object. It is attracting every object towards the earth's center. This is why we are stuck to the earth's crust always. Though we are we stay or we live on the outermost layer of the earth, but we never fall down. We never fall down. Why? Because of this gravitational force. It causes objects to drop on the ground and water to flow downhill. Gravitational force of an object is more if it has more weight than the other object. So gravitational force depends on the weight of any object. The more weight the object has, the more will be the gravitational force on the object. The less weight the object has, the less will be the gravitational force. This is why, suppose from a 10-storied building, from the roof, you are dropping two balls at the same time. One is simply a plastic ball, another is a metal ball made up of iron. Which ball will reach the ground first?
The metal ball.
Metal ball.
Why? Because the gravitational pull on the metal ball will be more than that of the plastic ball. Yes, and this is because the metal ball is heavier than the plastic ball. So the more weight will be, the more will be the gravitational force that will act on the object. If the two objects are very close to each other, then the gravitational force is more. And if there is the distance increases, the gravitational force will decrease. The same thing that I have told you. The main thing is the more weight the object will have, the more will be the gravitational force. With the increase in the weight, the gravitational force or gravitational pull will increase. With the decrease in the weight, the gravitational pull will also decrease. So only this much is written about gravitational force. You have learned much more than that. Okay, but for this chapter, you will have to learn only this much. Next type of force that is described here, that is the muscular force. The force that is exerted by the muscles, the force that is exerted by the muscles of our body, that is called the muscular force. For example, lifting a school bag. So when you are lifting a school bag, okay, your school bags nowadays, they are heavy or not? Are they heavy?
Yes, ma'am, of course.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Many books we have to carry.
So the more you will, the more higher classes you will go to the next class and next class, then what will happen? The weight of your school bag will increase or decrease? it will
increase. Ma'am, increase.
Yes, that is quite natural. So when you are lifting your school bag, then what type of force you are applying? You are applying
muscular force.
Yes, because your muscles are involved. When you are pulling it, you are using your muscles. Okay, so this is why this force is known as muscular force. For pushing the door, not only the door, for pushing anything, for pulling anything or pushing anything, for kicking the football, for all these kinds of work that we do using our hands or legs or muscles of our hands or legs. They are called, that force will be called the muscular force.
Muscular force.
Here you can see that's it. So just the definition and examples, nothing more is written here. So you will have to read only this much. What is muscular force and the example of it? It's quite easy, right? Isn't it?
So yes,
next one is magnetic force that can move certain objects. That is called magnetic force.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, Amitrujit. Yes.
Ma'am, look at this. This is magnetic force.
Oh, so you have magnets with you? That's very good. Yes. So that is the magnetic force, the force by which, very good. So one of your friend Amitrajit is showing us it live. He's showing us the experiment that you will have to do also. You can see in the let's perform box, you will have to do it. He's showing us, that's very good. Amitrajit has the magnet and he's showing us the magnetic force. You all can see it. That's very good, Amitrajit. So the force by which any magnet pulls any object.
I can't see Amitrajit.
Okay, maybe there is some network problem, but it's visible. He has shown it. Okay, very good. So the force that by which the magnets can pull any object, especially the irons, towards it, that is called the magnetic force. You know that magnets can attract the metals, especially like irons. Okay, so if you have, there is a box, an activity box you can see. Let's perform an activity box. You can perform this activity at your home yourself, okay? It's very easy. Let's see what you will have to do. The aim of this activity is to study about the magnetic force. You will just watch the magnetic force. You will observe the magnetic force. What are the things that you will need to perform this activity? You will need iron nails and a china dish or a magnet. So make sure that the dish on which you will put the iron nails, that will not be made up of metal. Made up of china dish means it can be made up of any type of glasses also. Any glass or plastic, just written china dish. So iron nails and magnets. Make sure on which you will keep the iron nails, they are not made up of metal. So what is the method? You will have to take some iron nails and put it in the china dish and bring the magnet close to the china dish. If you bring the magnet very close to the dish, what will happen? All the iron nails will be attracted by the magnet and they will just fix or attach to the magnet. What you will see, what is the observation? The iron nails start getting attracted towards the magnet. And what is the conclusion of this activity, of this experiment? This experiment shows that the magnet has force which attracts the iron nails towards it. Okay, that's it. It's very easy. You can do it yourself. Amitrajit has just done it in front of all of you. So you can do it yourself. Next type of force is electrostatic force. Now look here and listen to me very carefully. The force existing between two charged particles at a distance, that is called electrostatic force. And now who will tell me that what are the different charges that are present in our nature or in any charged particles? How many types of charges are there?
Electron, proton, neutron.
No, the charges that you can see in the battery.
So, ma'am, so it will be DC current and AC current.
No, just simple. You are going to, yes, Devolin, your answer is correct, but you are going to too much details. Don't go to that details. Things are written in very basic way, in basic form here. Positive and negative.
Negative, yes, ma'am.
Just positive. You have seen the positive and negative plus and minus sign on the batteries, on the cells that you have got. So these indicate the positive charges and negative charges. So if any particle is charged, so it may not be connected to the switchboard, or it may not be connected to any battery or cell. Simply we can create the charge. How we can create the charge? That is also given in this activity box, in the following activity box. During the winters it works well. So any type of
solar electrostatic force. Electrostatic force.
Yes, you can. So the force existing between two charged particles, that is called electrostatic force. This force is attractive. Yes, see, Junaid is showing us the comb and the pieces of paper. See how the comb has attracted the pieces, small pieces of paper. That's very good, Junaid. The students are showing the activities live in the class. That's very good, very good, very good. So this is how a class should be. I appreciate it. Very good, students. So now let's see what Junaid has done. So what you will have to do here, look at the activity box. The aim of this activity is to study about electrostatic force. The things that you need is paper and comb. Paper means very small pieces of paper. Okay. Now, what is the method? Now, shred the paper onto into small pieces. That means you will have to tear it into very small pieces. Then rub the comb on your hair for some time. It will be very good if the hair is dry. And if the season is winter season, it will work best. But in all the season, all the other seasons, it will work also. Bring the comb closer to the paper pieces. So after combing your hair a few times, two or three times, you bring the same comb towards the paper pieces, pieces of the papers. And now what you will see, what will be the observation for this activity? The pieces of paper, they will get stuck to the comb because of the electrostatic force. So when you have used the comb, you have rubbed the comb in your hair for two or three times, what happens? The comb gets charged, okay? For a temporary period of time, not permanently, okay? After some time, what you will see? Those papers will fall down. They will drop down from the comb, right? It will only stay for a particular period of time, which is very less. It's a very, very much... For a few seconds only, yes. After that, they will fall down. So Junaid is keep doing that. He's keeping doing that. Okay, okay. So, yes, yes. Very good, very good. So you will have to rub the comb two or three times or more than that in your hair. If your hair is dry, it will work best. It will create some temporary charges on the comb. Okay, temporary charges. Because when two dry objects will be rubbed against each other, then the charges will be formed, okay, but temporarily. Now, how we will know that a temporary charge has been created, it has been formed in that comb? So this is also to prove that. So if you just take few pieces of paper, they will attract it, okay? And this is why we need to take small pieces of paper. If you take a huge sheet of paper, it will not attract the whole sheet of paper. Yeah, it may attract only one corner of the sheet of paper, but not the whole sheet of paper, because the amount of force, the amount of energy that is created in this way, it is very less. Okay? Let's go to the next part. I can see, okay, Samia Rahman and Divyanka Roy, you both have raised your hand. One by one, you tell me why you have raised your hand. Okay? Yes. Who will tell first? Samia, okay, you tell it.
Ma'am, my question is, what is the difference between magnetic force and gravitational force?
Okay, magnetic force is exerted by magnets. Okay, and gravitational force is a pull by our earth towards its center. Magnetic force is only exerted by magnets. Magnets are also one kind of materials. Magnetic rocks are also found. Okay, magnets are also, we also get the magnets from the rocks. Okay. And these are called the magnets. From the rocks, we get the magnets. And the magnets have a particular character that it can attract only the metals towards it. But the gravitational force will not attract only the metals. It will attract anything that will go to the upward direction. Anything, whether it is made up of plastic, whether it is... Even if we jump, we will... if there was no gravitational force, what would happen? If we would jump, we would go to the space, right? Yes, and we would never come back to our home. So this is what happens because of the gravitational force. So gravitational force never distinguishes between whether it is a metal or plastic or glass or a human being or plant. Whatever you will throw to the upward direction, it will pull towards the Earth center. But magnetic force will only attract magnets, especially the iron. Okay. This is the basic difference. And there are so many other differences. I'm not going in details. It will take the whole class because magnetic force is a huge topic to discuss. You will read it in the next class. Now, Divyanka Roy.
One more question also.
Yes. Yes, Samia.
Ma'am, in our book, they are having six types of force, but actually, they are having one more force, that is bioenergy force.
Yes. So many, see, many other different types of forces are there. And the natural forces, we can also distinguish it by a natural force and artificial force. It depends. It depends how the chapter is prepared. See, like one more example I can give you about the type of soil. Sometimes you read there are three types of soil, and sometimes you read there are seven types of soil, right? Five types of soil. So in some books, they are written only three types of soil. It depends on which class the book belongs to, which class. Okay. The more you will go to the higher classes, the more details you will learn. Okay. So, but the where it is written three types of soils are there, that is also not wrong. Because those three types are the main three types, the basic types that will give rise to the other types of soil. Just like this. So these are the main types of forces that we use, we can see, we can apply in our daily life. And many different types of forces are still there that you will read in details in the next few classes. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, please see this. Ma'am?
Yes? Who is this? Junaid?
Ma'am, can you see this?
My credit, yes. Yes.
The north magnet and the south magnet.
Yes. So,
if we touch the north and north, the magnets not attach.
They will repel. Okay, they will reject each other. So magnets, yes, generally attract each other, but the same poles of the magnet, they reject or repel each other. So north, yes, side, ma'am, of one magnet, it will always reject or repel the another side of another magnet. But the, yes, opposite, ma'am, sides will always attract each other. The north side will always attract the south side. Okay. Now,
yes, ma'am.
Yes, Divyanka, you tell me why you have raised your hand.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I also have two questions. Ma'am, first, in the gravitational force, it is written that gravitational force of an object is more if it has more weight than the other object. Ma'am, here, other object means that which object has been told?
That means if we compare, if we have two objects and if we compare their weight. Just I have told you, if you have ball, those both of them are balls, but one is made up of plastic material, another is made up of a metal. So if we compare them, because so many objects are there in on our earth, right? There are so many living and non-living, so many that countless, we can't even count. So it depends on the weights of those objects. Okay, the more weight the object will have, the more gravitational pull will also be.
Okay, ma'am. And ma'am, another question from that electrostatic force. Ma'am, in that let's perform box, when we come here, you have told the charge is produced between them. So, ma'am, which type of charge is it? Means positive or negative?
Ion. No, both. Positive and negative, both will be created. Mostly the positive ions are created, but few negative ions will also be there. These are called the charged particles. When we rub two things, especially two dry things, against each other, then temporarily few charged particles are created. They will create the electrostatic force and they will attract the papers. Okay?
Okay,
they will,
ma'am,
not,
okay,
differentiate that whether it is metal or not. Like magnetic force you have seen, they will only attract the metal. But in electrostatic force, they will not differentiate it as metals or any other object. So they will also attract any other charged particle. Okay. So Shojoshish Dev, you unmute your device. Shojoshish Dev, you unmute your device.
Yes, ma'am.
See, the class time is already over.